Hello there, internet. Good news. I screwed that up. So good news, everyone, or good news, internet. Which is a ripoff of, Futurama. Which is a really good show. That and half the other people on the internet. But I'm not doing a internet video today. Well, it is, but it's not a... I'm not frapsing. This is real life. Good news, everyone! We're in a car. That's what I was gonna do. A 97 Sunfire 2.4 liter quad 4 dual overhead cam. Modified, hopped up to about right around 200 horsepower. Yeah, ooh, only 200 horsepower. Well, they only put out 150 at the crank stock, so eat me. Okay. Full exhaust. Extended tube header, full exhaust, all the way back to a glass pack in the back with a resonator. It's got a high flow intake and higher performance aftermarket camshafts. If you were ever really a J-body guy back in the day, they are known as secret cams. Although there's only a handful of people that were on the forum, J-body forum, that really know what that's going to mean. But, yeah, this is my basically my good gas mileage daily driver today. Although, it does have a little bit of power still for what it is. Get the radio on if you can hear that. Not so much bass. Got too much bass. Yeah, it's not got a full Alpine system with Infinity speakers. I was sitting here thinking to myself, where am I going to mount the camera in the Mustang? Only place I could think of that wouldn't hurt the car, where the mount would be removable if I ever wanted to without hurting anything, while at the same time being able to see what's going on, would be the rearview mirror. Or this car's, or this one's mounted right now. Because the helmet cam leaves somewhat to be desired. It lets you look around. I'm not going to do a dash cam. Not on that car. Because you got the 3M adhesive, which the porousness, I don't want that on my dash. Domelight, handle it, no problem. But dash, no. It ain't going to hurt the Domelight. I just got to remember where the Domelight is in the Mustang. I'm not sure it's going to work or not, like it is on this one, but... windshield. That was a great idea. Windshield's a little filthy. I'm sitting. This is mainly a little bit of a test video here to see how this works. Come on, plane. My expensive ass Bosch wiper blades, although they're damn six or seven year old wiper blades. They still work. I mean, not that great. The second gear on this car. That was with the clutch all the way in. I wasn't able to downshift it enough, rev it up enough. I should have put it, tried to downshift it into second there. Yeah, that's the one thing that's wrong with this car is it's second gear. The synchros are gone. You can upshift. Here, I'll downshift into second here. There. But you ain't downshifting this car into second gear unless you're at a low RPM. And you rev match it. And I heel toe downshift this car. Even, like right now, I got my heel on the brake. So I can do that. So I can rev the engine with my toe. Which I've been. Oh, train just went by. Shit. Which I've been told is the opposite of what most people do it. I guess most people. Whoa. Brake with their heel, no wait, brake with their toe, and then bump the throttle with their heel. Well, that just doesn't make sense to me. That's, you know, that's doesn't feel naturally to me. So I heel toe brake with doing it the other way. Instead of like this, I do it like that. And this car, believe it or not, the Sunfire, using that method, is so easy to rev heel toe brake. It's just ridiculous. Which I just learned to do, happen to do that in a second, so I just do it out of all the time now by default. They got snow tires on this right now. Where is this guy going up there? I don't ever beat on this, drive this car hard. I'm granny shifting no matter what I do. That wasn't full throttle. That was close, but it wasn't full throttle. I was getting on it, but that wasn't tearing up the car or anything. I do want to drive a little bit towards a little bit fun. Damn, that Volkswagen's gone. Because I am making a video. By now, which I'm not sure if anybody will ever notice if I don't say anything, but you may have noticed something in the car is missing. No, not right now. There is that Volkswagen. See? Yeah. Rearview mirror's gone. I did a video earlier just driving around. And I can look in the mirror and talk to the camera. I got toothpaste on my lip, I think. You can probably see that in the camera. I haven't shaved in a few days. So I know you can see my face, my hat, my kick-ass, whatever that is, hat. It's actually my work hat now. So, you know, that kind of helps. If I had a passenger over here, you'd be able to see them. It's actually a nice internal view. There's the Volkswagen. For the camera, it's actually a good place for it. Where you don't want to use a helmet cam, which I seriously thought about bringing the helmet with me and switching back and forth between the two for this video. But, God, that'd be so much work. Fun, which I might end up doing on the truck. I can't mount the camera like this in my pickup. I'd probably, if I was going to mount it like this in the pickup, I'd just mount it on the back window. It would look about the same as this. And it would work out. I'm kind of wondering, hoping I get a good mounting place on the bike. Thank you. look fast on the camera, it might not. But this is actually taking it pretty easy. I'm only doing 60. Because I got the snow tires on the car. I don't know why I downshifted into third. But the Potenzas, the Bridgestones on the car, I don't do it. I can go through these turns at 70, 80 miles per hour with this car. Slow way down here. This is usually about a 70 mile an hour turn if I'm hauling ass. I'm doing 55. Birdies! Not sure what I can do with the bike. Bike, probably do it at 90, no problem. Maybe 100, but I'm not gonna, never gonna find out. I think the fastest I've gone through there, those turns on the bike, it's about 80 something, it's probably 75 in the 70s. I think I've done, actually, I don't think they do the turns much faster than in a car. People are like, sport bikes, they go through the, they can take turns like crazy. Well, yes, they can. However, they really don't take corners any faster than a real sports car can. Like a Corvette or probably even a Mustang will be able to go through a turn about as fast as your a sport bike rider's going to. Now, I suppose at full speed where you're at the limit, the bike's probably going to do it at a faster speed. Unless you're, like, talking against, like, a race car or something. You know, I doubt it. But full with my good tires on this car, and maybe if I was in like a Corvette or something, I would be able to take one of those cars like through here after a couple passes, especially this is a really shady turn though. Especially those other two, the S-bends back there, at full, well, damn near full speed where it's at the limit of the car, I'd be able to do that. I'm actually very good at telling, testing, and feeling the limits of tires, the suspension, and cars. It's like through there, you might think that I was pushing it a little bit hard, or that was kind of hairy. I wasn't. This is not driving fast for me. Well, if I want to drive fast, I usually don't do it anymore, though. I don't want to be getting tickets and crap like that. Like there, this we're doing 65. I just know that that's going to be the farthest I want to push it with these tires on this car. Section where I took the last picture of the year photo tag on the bike. Yeah, see the Dodge County sign? This is where I took the last photo tag picture of the year last fall, and nobody else tagged it. Wes got it on the spring already, which really surprised me. Which also surprised me that he fell down and broke his leg on his bike a couple week or two ago. And I haven't taken off full throttle in this car when I wound it out back there. Second gear, but really since I've been out driving it, I don't really get if I don't tear stuff up, I've gotten this car to run and get it into the 14s in the quarter, but I just don't do it anymore. It's not worth it. It's not worth driving shit hard. Well, you can have fun, but it's not worth beating on stuff to the point to where you're going to wear shit prematurely or break something, so you got to fix it. You know? Rather have something nice. You know, which this car isn't nice, but Rice Lake State Park, never actually been in there. This is why I don't want to live in the cities. Look how open this is. You know, you got the people, I guess if you live in the city, it's a trip, and you don't, it's not like, that's the only time right there, there's a car coming, it's not a cop. I don't have a radar detector anymore. You have a radar detector out here? Out in the boondocks? Jesus Christ, you can basically do what you want. As long as you're smart enough, and you start coming over, like, hills and shit where you can't see a long ways off, you take it easy. Like, there's houses here, and you got these little crests. You slow down a little bit. Guy could be pulled out of a driveway, you know? I can't see what's past this guy's driveway right now. Hope I know there's, I know what's there, because I drive this road, but you don't know what's there. There we go. It's clear. And now you can sit out. I'm not going to accelerate in the car. But like if you're on the bike, now you can accelerate in and, you know, drive into the turns. I don't feel sorry for these people like on sport bikes getting cut, doing wheelies in town and shit. It's like, you're the dumbass that's out there yet doing it. Are people that race in cars? The drag race. Now we're going to go down to the warehouse district, which I can see if you live in LA or New York. Those are big cities, but still, at least you have to go up like in the warehouse districts or something. Look what we got out here. We got all these straight roads. This is a curvy one bit here. These are really only the only real curves out here where I live. But this is the place. Got the legal on the safety Nazis. You know what? Screw that shit. You gotta go out in the middle of the country, out here on a straight, nice long straightaway, which there are some. There are some serious straightaways where you might not be able to tell right now from the recording, but there are some straightaways out here that you can see for a good mile or two in both directions. No one is gonna pull out in front of you. Nothing, I mean a deer, but you know, you're gonna see it trotting across the field. Nothing's going to catch you by surprise. It's just not going to happen. Maybe a squirrel can run out of a grassy ditch or something, whatever. But you're still not endangering anybody else. There are safe places to race, drag race and shit on the street. Not in town, but there are safe places to do it.
Hey, we're in town now.
This is Rose Street. I kind of wanted to come in on Mineral Springs. That's a neat little drive I forgot. But we're gonna. What time is it? It is 4:30. I'm gonna swing by Radio Shack, see if they have 64 gig cards for this camera. I got a 32 in there now. Horribly unpretty place to live. I mean, it really is boring some places, but it's just the snow that I hate so goddamn much. It's a cop. Stupid cop SUVs. And we're gonna drive through Owatonna here. I want to see what it looks like in town, too. I don't think anyone's going to see the camera, but hopefully a cop doesn't notice my damn rearview mirror is gone. Yeah, I recorded in the with the rearview mirror on, it might as well be standing in front of the mirror talking to you guys. This big mirror right here, just up in my face. We're gonna see. Hey, look at that shit. They did have two of them. They have 64 gig micro SD cards. And the batteries get low on the camera, I believe. I might need three batteries. I've got two. I might end up needing three. I'll probably end up buying a third one. They're about $20 a piece. They're not horrible. They got them at Walmart. I'll probably just wait till a payday or whatever the hell. Look over, there's a blue light blinking on the goddamn camera. I wish I would have brought an extra battery. That's not a fair test. God damn it. Oh well, I can just look up GoPro Hero Plus 3 Plus or whatever battery life. Ooh, Beamer. There's getting to be way too many BMWs. I got two of these bitches. Class 10, 64 gig. That'll be enough. I'm assuming it'll sense the battery's low and it'll auto shut down and it'll beep. Assuming that's what it is. But yeah, that Wi-Fi, holy shit, that, so it's like the battery shouldn't be dead yet. I got like that, the battery's supposed to last like an hour and 10 minutes, hour and 15 minutes battery life is what you're supposed to have in a goddamn, on a battery. It's like, why the hell is the battery going dead? The Wi-Fi, well, the Wi-Fi uses more juice than freaking the camera does, the recording does. Stoic truck. We're driving by where I work right now. Yeah, these weren't cheap. Anybody that knows how much a Class 10 64 gig micro SD card costs? I got two of them sitting there. I need them. Oh, Sterling's still not fixed. Still sitting back there. Pretty stretch of road. I'm turning the camera off now because the battery's low. That, and I know the video cards gotta be getting full too by now. So I am purposely shutting off and conserving, you know, space now. Pisses me off about that battery. Hopefully the battery lasts longer than the video, long enough to gauge how much these cards will hold. Because I got a 16 gig in there now. And the cards down here, they'll hold four times that. So, let's get some Jackie Jeans. Want some of this shit. Go through the drive-thru with the camera. Let's see. I can find it. I get a number 2.
Alright, what size and what drink?
Whatever medium is, and I'm trying to find the drinks on the menu at the moment. I'm blind.
Alright, we have Pepsi products. Diet Pepsi.
I guess the only diet you got. Can we get Diet Mountain Dew?
Yep, we have Diet Mountain Dew.
Alright, that'll work.
Alright, so a medium Diet Mountain Dew?
Yep.
Alright. And will that complete your order today?
Yep, that's it.
Alright, your total's gonna be 714 at the first window. Thank you.
Thanks. I wonder if you guys can hear that or not. Stereo back on. Yep, got the food. They caught me off guard, otherwise I would have recorded it and they handed it to me. Super burrito. That's gonna be a little hard to eat in the car though.